What's up guys, Bogdan here and welcome to the Import Export Hub channel. Okay, so before I begin the quiz question of the week, which is the largest exporter of honey in terms of weight in the world? Is it China, Australia or New Zealand? Sorry guys, I'm not gonna reveal the answer just yet because I have some really interesting news to share with you this week. Stay tuned and sometime during this video I will reveal the correct answer. Stay tuned. Thank you guys for your patience. I don't want to play with you, but I really have some important news to share with you. And the first one is coming from the logistics world. It seems that DSV Panalpina is once again announcing a large acquisition. This time it's Agility Global Integrated Logistics. Just 2 years after DSV acquired Panalpina. The value of this acquisition is about $4.2 billion, and with this acquisition, this DSV Panalpina will become the world's third largest transport and logistics company provider, at least based on revenues. This acquisition will have operations in more than 19 countries. And from my point of view, this is an excellent opportunity and really confirms the trend in the world that about having a strong footprint in the emerging markets from Asia, South America, Africa and the Middle East. They expect to close the transaction in the third quarter this year, and until then they will continue to operate independently. Now moving on to the next news, which is coming also from the transport industry, this time from Maersk. It seems that Maersk added another intermodal service from Asia to Europe, but this time to the Black Sea and Mediterranean. The service is called AE77. They have another intermodal service from Asia, but to the northern part of Europe. And both services are designed to offer customers a reliable option without major bottlenecks, see the recently Suez Canal incident, and of course a good transit time between 20 to 30 days at least for the AE77 service, so linking Asia to the Black Sea. And I've read that given the increase in the demand, it seems that Maersk already deployed an additional vessel for feeding Busan port with the Vostochny intermodal container port at the eastern end of the Trans-Siberian Railway. I really don't know anything about the freight price, but I think that this option will become very, very attractive for both importers and exporters, especially if we consider the current ocean freights from Asia to Europe. Now moving on to the third news, this time it's coming from the second largest container shipping company, MSC, and it's very interesting. They've announced that they've implemented the electronic bill of lading, which is marketed by them as WaveBL. After conducting a successful pilot program in the early 2020, if I remember correctly. Now, what we have to understand is that digitalization is good for all the stakeholders as long as there will be a common standard to which all the parties should adhere. The grounds from my perspective are already laid. Now it remains to be seen if there will be some intellectual property issues with patents and so on, but if this is the case, then the adoption rate will take longer. On the other hand, if those standards are open source and available for everybody, then the adoption rate will be much faster and broader. Because see the case with the shipping container, and by the way, this week was its 65th birthday, so happy birthday shipping container. It's because when Malcolm McLean introduced the shipping container, he was not that greedy in order to get rich quickly and get a patent for the shipping container. He left the shipping container available for everybody, and that's why the industry adopted the shipping container very, very quick and broadly. And that's my opinion. I might be wrong. If you have any ideas, don't forget to comment down below. So the largest exporter of honey in terms of weight is China. Now moving on to the next news. It seems that importers lost their pricing powers, and I highly recommend you reading this Q&A with Gottschmidt. It seems, anyway, he's covering topics like spot rates, contract rates, and so on. And basically, in the last decade or so, ocean freights were very, very low, and importers had their fair share of gains, and now it's hard for them to intake these crazy ocean freights. But then again, what Gottschmidt underlines, and I do agree with him 100%, is the fact that every shipper should see the transport provider as a trustworthy partner. Because after all, that's a business. You need a partnership, a trustworthy partnership with your service providers, especially the transport providers and the ocean freight providers. And finding reliable partners to whom you support when they are in need, and vice versa, is the essence of surviving in business. So yesterday I've uploaded the video in which I've covered the imports and the exports of the United States, and I've touched just a little bit the United States free trade agreements, focusing of course on the biggest one, which is NAFTA or USMCA, whatever you want to call it. And it's very interesting to see that the United States are thinking of establishing a new free trade agreement with Kenya. Now, I don't know if the United States are considering this potential, because it's a potential free trade agreement, as a measure to counterbalance China's presence in Kenya and in Africa in general, but it's worth thinking at the macro level instead. You have to ask yourself, is the United States looking for a market to diversify its exports and imports? Or they want to have a strong hold in Kenya in order to keep an eye on China? I don't say that this can be done both ways, but we have to see the larger picture and not just focus on this potential, I underline potential, free trade agreement. Anyway, remains to be seen in the future. And speaking of free trade agreements, Japan's parliament approved joining the world's largest free trade deal. And guys, that's where the things will happen in 5-10 years time. Sorry, Europe and the United States policymakers. Sorry once again, but I anticipate that if you passively wait, you will lose dominance, or at least what's left of it. But nonetheless, this RCEP agreement, it's worth following up, of course, and let's see in the medium and long term what will happen with this agreement, because it's the world's largest free trade agreement. Now moving on to Australia, and this is very, really, really interesting. I've lived to see this kind of news. China is investigating Australian wines exports for dumping. Usually, I would expect the European Union or the United States to investigate Chinese products that are dumped, but this is really interesting turn on events. I don't know if it's a geopolitical game, maybe, most probably, but then again, if the European Union and the United States investigated Chinese dumping practices, why not the other way around? And this time it's with Australian wines. Now, if I were a wine exporter from Australia, I would kindly ask the industry association to intervene and find a solution, because losing a market share of 30% in China, it's dangerous, if not suicidal. Nor the United States, Canada, or the United Kingdom will manage to absorb the market that Australia will lose in China. But that's my opinion. If you know the wine industry better than me, feel free to comment down below. And speaking of Australia, the trade ministers from both Australia and the United Kingdom negotiated a free trade agreement, and this agreement could be the biggest one for the United Kingdom after leaving the European Union. And I think that the UK will be more and more actively involved in establishing new free trade agreements with its former colonies. But that remains to be seen. Now, if this particular trade deal with Australia will be indeed a win-win deal remains to be seen, of course, especially after we will see it drafted. Okay, so that's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment in the section down below and smash the like and subscribe buttons. And until next time, keep your business safe. Thanks.